When you're creating a service-backed record type and you need more than 1,000 rows of source data, you need to enable syncing in batches because only 1,000 rows can be synced at a time. Depending on how the web service is configured for paging, you will choose which method to use for batching. In this video, I'll batch by sequential values, which uses a number rule input. You can also use a text rule input to batch by text, URL, or URI. Batching by a sequential value works by passing in a rule input for the batch number. Each batch, Appian will increase the batch number by 1 to get the next 1,000 rows. It keeps syncing until a successful call returns no data. In the generation flow, when you select a batching method, a rule input will be added to the integration and record data source. Let's start with the integration. On the right, in the rule input pane, I have a rule input for batch number that was automatically added because I selected syncing in batches in the creation flow. I'll use this rule input to add a query parameter. First, go to the API's documentation to see how it is configured for paging. If at all, not all APIs are able to sync in batches. You'll also need to find the correct name for the parameter, often called paging. In this example, I can see that the parameter is called page, so I'll use that as the name for the query parameter in the integration. The names need to match, so pay close attention to the API's documentation. For the value, I'll edit as an expression and use the rule input batch number. However, I need to check the documentation to see where the paging starts. In this case, the default is 1, so I'll leave it as is. However, sometimes the paging starts at 0. If it is 0, I would need to update the value to be RI bang batch number minus 1 because the Appian expression starts the sequence at 1 and I need it to start at 0. Next, I'll take a look at the record data source. Here, I also have a rule input for batch number and it's already configured in the generated expression. Let's test it. The expression will start with a batch number of 1, so I'll simply click Test Rule. I take note of the records that are returned. Next, I'll change the batch number to 2, and then click Test. Now, the next set of records are returned. Great! So, when I create my record type and save it, the sync will start. When it completes, I'll have all the data I need from my source. And whenever I do a full sync of my record type, the data will be similarly synced in batches.